Alright guys, so we're here with Watch Dogs Legion. This is my second time trying to record this game. It was a bit like it just wasn't working, so, and it froze and it crashed, but I'm hoping now it'll be fine, hopefully. Let's just hope. I'm gonna just create a new game. I didn't get far before it broke. I got what? Yeah, so what happened is it broke mid cutscene pretty much. So we got through like a little bit of the beginning segment, which sucks because now I'm just gonna rush through the beginning segment instead of like, cause now you guys don't get my like first reaction to the game. Which it really sucks. Like it was genuinely going well. I'll try to talk about a little bit of what I talked about during the intro. One of the things I talked about is just how I'm looking so much more forward to playing this game now than I originally did. Because if you guys don't remember, it was pretty much set to be an RPG. And that's how it was for like 2 years or so. And then they took it over to this more just action game, which I feel like was really good because all Ubisoft games ended up becoming RPGs for some reason. Fallout. Sorry, I've been playing a lot of Fallout 76. But, I mean, Far Cry, like, New Dawn was RPG, and then AC was RPG since 2016. Then you had them trying to do the same thing with this. You had Ghost Recon Breakpoint doing it, and it just wasn't working for all their games, almost. But now we're here with Watch Dogs 2.
Ah, London. What a town. History around every corner, and a tourist photographing it. Pubs serving up a pint and a smile. All that music, theatre and art. And multiculturalism. And the world's oldest underground, the Tube. The class of cities, really. Top shelf stuff. Only took 12,000 years to build it up, and one night to tear it all down.
Our status.
Perimeter security's down, but plenty of your flying friends about.
Fucking hell.
Dalton, no time to waste.
Yes, ma'am.
As I was saying, though, intro before the game broke, this game looks really great for being a PS4 game. And load times are good so far.
Leaving these security threats to the authorities?
That's rich, Bagley. The government would sooner arrest us for trying to help than actually do something useful.
We'll have to sort this one on our own.
Carefully, Dalton.
Bagley, are you detecting a little worry in Sabine's voice?
Brilliant. Asking the computer about feelings. This explains so much.
Shut it, you two, and get to work.
There she is.
Yeah, this game just it looks really good. And also, like, before it actually crashed, like, the game itself runs so smoothly. I would give you guys more of, like, the cinematic playstyle that I did originally, but I want to get back to the part I was at.
If they don't shoot me, I won't shoot them. How's that?
But yeah, like, the game itself, it runs smoothly. It looks great. Also, it's not bad on your hard drive in any way. It's only like 33 gigabytes on PS4 right now. I'm pretty sure it's the same on Xbox as well. There we go. Go near it, I dare you. And and get wrecked. Oh, his neck. That poor man's neck. They've got loads of dead
set gear down here. And why do you suppose that is?
What? How did they get their hands on it?
I don't know. But someone wants to make it look like Dead Set was here.
Shit. You need to proceed with extreme caution, Dalton.
As I'm just full sprinting.
Who are these men in black anyway?
Nothing identifying. I suspect that's by design.
Oh, fuck me. The entire place is rigged to blow.
Jesus, those canisters. Buckley, is that...
RDX nitrogen. Enough to level Parliament.
Can you locate a detonator, Bagley?
Not exactly, but there's a device streaming a fuckload of encrypted data from the floor above you.
Yeah, that fits the bill. On my way.
Their profiles are heavily encrypted. No identifying information.
Ghosts in this system.
Bagley, is that not the detonator?
No, but it's a transmitter sending a signal to a device on the floor above us. Safe to assume that would be the detonator we're looking for.
Let's go.
They've staged Dead Set propaganda all around the bombs. These pricks are going to blow up Parliament and hang it on us.
Not if you get to that detonator first.
I'm full sprinting, man. I'll get to the detonator first. I'm just surprised. The game looks so good. I think this will be the first game that starts, like, turning Ubisoft around, because... You guys may not agree with me, but the last few Ubisoft games have just been kind of poo-poo, you know, in the long run. Like, yeah, they're fun initially because it's a brand new game, but they've been poo-poo in the long run, for sure. It just seems like they're doing better now.
These men in black are they, but brass bollocks to set up in the center of government.
There's the detonator. Let's hope it doesn't break this time. Because this is the cutscene it broke on. Dude, oh my god, I was so scared because it was just sitting in black for so long.
And it's definitely live. Bagley, I'm going to need some help with this.
Yes, you are, but sadly, I'm locked out.
Fuck.
Well, we don't have a chance without Bagley.
Wait, I might know a workaround. We trained in manual overrides at MI5.
You're full of surprises.
Be quick about it.
All right, Bagley, do your thing.
I'm in. And the bombs have just armed themselves. Well, that may complicate matters.
Fuck's sake.
Can you defuse them or not?
Of course I can, but I might also trip another failsafe and vaporize you, so fair warning.
I expect this to draw some attention your way, Dalton.
Oh, I'm counting on it.
Company at our back door. Dalton, we've got some heat here at HQ.
How long is this going to take, Bagley?
Depends how often you interrupt me with questions.
All right, everyone. Faces on, guns out. It's about to get real.
Fuck.
I mean, we already pretty much know what's going to happen. They've told us that... We have to build a resistance, and if there's already a resistance, then there's nothing to build. Is this going to be our first time with a gunplay?
I'm certainly not too far off. Looks clear. Gotta check our next area. Somebody's shooting.
It feels nice.
Bagley, update. Let's just say I'm both impressed and
annoyed. It has aim assist.
Bagley, tell me you're close. I'm through security. Now wading through terabytes of decoy code looking for the detonation sequence. No!
Must be close by.
It doesn't actually tell me how to reload, though. Which I kinda don't like. Oh, it's triangle, okay. That's a weird button for a reload. I gotta mess with my sensitivity.
Getting shot at here.
Yeah, my sensitivity feels weird. Oh, what is that? Oh, it just shows me everything with like a hacking radius. Interesting. So it actually, so it like, that button I click shows me everything.
You need to pull the controller wire.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm fucking not. Pull the wire.
If this gets me blown up.
Bombs defused. See? That wasn't so bad, was it?
Bagley, you bastard. You're gonna give me a bloody heart attack then.
Whoa, what the fuck am I looking at?
It appears Parliament is not the only target. More bombs are going live as we speak.
On screen, Bagley.
Fucking hell, we need to get the word out. Those sites need to be evacuated.
They're spread out all over London. There isn't any time.
But my sister's at the Tone Conference. We have to do something.
I picked up a transmitter on the roof that is sending out a signal to the other bomb sites. If you can reach it...
I can shut it all down. Sabine!
Fuck! Dalton, we're breached! Go! The roof!
Damn. Yeah, so I mean, we knew that, like... We knew that,
Sabine, what's going on?
We're being raided. It's a bloodbath. Our protocol is to wipe everything, including Bagley.
I need him for the transmitter.
I know, but if they get him, they get everything. Names, ops, locations.
Okay, I'll do it the old-fashioned way. Wipe him.
Yes, wipe me.
Do it, Sabine, and get the hell out of there.
Fuck.
Oh, can okay. I just go through these?
Bagley's down. You're on your own. Dalton, if this goes...
It won't.
Oh, download.
I'll see you at the rally point. I promise.
Good luck.
Yeah, so we already knew that, like, the resistance gets wiped. Okay. Oh! Oh no, how do I swap shoulders? Oh no! How do I swap shoulders? This is like something I need to figure out now. Is there not a button to? Yeah, I don't think there's a button actually to swap shoulders. Interesting. Oh. It's weird. Some doors you open with L1, some doors you open with triangle. It's a bit strange. Not going to lie.
Where are you? Okay.
With some important work.
Important work? Killing thousands of people.
Exactly. To save the world. You do know Londoners have died before, The plague, the Great Fire, the Blitz. It's not much fun. But destruction is always the cure. And it begins today. Zero day.
Oh,
time for a hard reset.
Oh my god.
Oh damn. That was like a gruesome death too. Like that was a hardcore death. I actually, like, we just met him and they somehow made me feel bad that he died that quick.
Authorities are asking residents to remain in their homes as the situation continues to develop. We have received no official casualty total, but it is expected.
Sorry if the game's loud, by the way.
Candlelight vigils that brought closure to thousands of families and indeed to an entire city. London is now laser
Downing Street, where Nigel Cass, CEO of private military company Albion, received a mandate to secure London. Cass has vowed to hunt down DedSec. Terrorist responses failed. Albion used cutting-edge artificial intelligence systems and autonomous drones to capture the remaining members of DedSec. A stark warning to would-be insurgents.
Corporations are posting record profits due to increased efficiencies in production and distribution, enabled by the use of technologies initially developed and approved for security purposes.
Long-overdue cleanup as crime numbers take a dive. Illegal gambling, drug trafficking and prostitution all down following prosecutions of the leaders of four of London's five largest criminal syndicates. The streets of Camden and Brixton.
Mandate is extended indefinitely by the government, life finally begins to return to normal. Curfews and travel restrictions have been lifted in all boroughs, thanks to the deployment.
Big news outlets, reports of rioting in Trafalgar Square have been greatly exaggerated, possibly by foreign meddlers pushing a false narrative through social media. Albion is in complete control of a few...
about the circulation of fake news, conspiracy theories persisting in dark corners of the internet that terrorist group DedSec were framed for the bombings have been roundly rejected. Our own reporters could not find a single Londoner willing to expound those theories on camera. The facts any other story.
I heard that is, I also, like, I heard graffiti is actually like a side activity you could do. I don't know how true that is, but I saw something about that on YouTube. That you can actually, like, just do graffiti. Which is cool. I'm pretty sure the second game had that. You just pick an icon and it would just appear up there, and that's what you graffitied. I think it was the second game. I might be thinking of, like, a completely different series. Brave New World Trophy.
I need to assemble a team, but I can't reboot DedSec alone. Let me break into London CTOS and see who's available.
Oh, so we're gonna pick like our starting character right now, and then eventually we'll unlock more characters. Interesting.
I'm Claire Waters, and we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, okay, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I'll say they should all be lined up and shot.
You don't find it awfully convenient that they've been fingered as the attackers, but we've seen no proof?
Look at Tone! Look at our city! What more proof do you need?
Well, Colin, I'd say you have to look at their history of non-violent action.
Dude, that was scary. I thought I was supposed to go that way.
In the past few months than DedSec ever has. I smell a scapegoat. Now I have Emily calling in. Emily, what's your take?
You're absolutely right, Claire. The government's just framing DedSec because they want to make it seem like they have this under control. They probably have no clue who was behind the bombings. But that doesn't look good on the news, does it? DedSec's been a thorn in their side. Who better to pin it on?
Angie, I have you next. What do you make of all this?
I think if anything, DedSec showed their true colors. It's terrifying to think we harbored such a dangerous element for years. Terrorists in our own backyard.
Do you find DedSec more frightening than the different gangs in London like Clan Kelly?
Clan Kelly might set your shop on fire and maybe they'd kill you, but even they wouldn't try to blow up all of Parliament.
Next, I have Crypto King. Do you feel safer using a pseudonym?
Everyone should. Why make it easier for them to track you? And now we've seen what they're capable of and how far they're willing to go. Hold on.
I'm interesting. Bloom. Everything always comes back to CTOS and Bloom. Well, aren't they the same thing? Bloom was just a renamed CTOS.
Shit. Situation is worse than I thought. But there's a candidate. Looks like you're dead sex best hope.
Wait, what? I pick between these guys. Select your first operative. I guess I would pick. Out of these, I don't know. Debt collector. It's a P9. I saw someone in here with like an MP5 or something like that. Yeah, her. He gets a. I'll go with this guy. Internet celebrity. Failed motorcycle license test. Personal motorcycle. I'll go with him. Why not? Justin. Might as well. Just try out something a little different. He wouldn't be my first choice. I would have chose the girl with MP5. But I was like, why not get an actual vehicle as my first thing rather than a gun? Because I think what I'm going to do probably for the at least the first little while of the game is probably do stealth the best I possibly can. So there's not really a point in worrying about guns right now, because I can guarantee you that stealth's going to be like the best way to do some of the beginning stuff probably. Until you at least get like better upgrades or overall like better at the game. This is my first look at London, like, actually playing, and it looks great. Am I just taking this car?
Glad to see you're alive, if you're still committed to the cause.
Wow. Got some missions and some data.
DedSec needs you. I'll send you the coordinates to our last safe house. Meet me there.
Sure.
Wow, these cars actually, they don't handle bad, but they are weird to drive. It doesn't feel quite right. Yeah, they kind of feel weird. Ooh. Ooh, that's not my fault. They all walked into that. Yeah, so after this video, I'm gonna have to just mess with my settings the best I can. Ooh, also, I just realized. Music is gonna have to be off. I can't have music on. I was copyrighted. I was copyright-striked the entire Kingdom Hearts 2 playthrough. So music has to be all the way off. Sorry, guys. That's just the way it has to be. I guess while I'm in here, just go through everything and just see what I can do. That's all fine. I just need to mess with my sensitivity. I don't know what I want to. I guess I would lower it. Not by much, like 40. I don't know. It felt weird. I don't know if I would want to lower it or, like, bring it up more. For the car sensitivity, I definitely want to lower it. Probably the drone sensitivity, too. I don't know. I'm probably just going to have to get used to the game and then it'll feel fine. But okay. It's weird too, cause the camera's like not auto resetting. You know what I mean? Like I have to manually actually move it, which is kind of strange. Why did I get out of that side of the car? That's the wrong side. Aren't I supposed to drive on the right side? I'm wondering.
I've downloaded a patch to your optics so you can access our security system. It's set up so that I can't just let someone who isn't DedSec in. You'll have to do the manual override.
A manual override to the secret entrance? If I get to hack some nodes later, I'm gonna geek out.
Okay, there's this one. Oh, I have to... Cool. Yeah, I mean the game, it just look, it looks so good.
I broke a fucking Dabra.
Oh. I was like, what? I mean that kind of ruins like the flow of the game. I have to know, but it's fine. I mean they seem to be relatively fast. Like it seems to be like on Ghost of Tsushima's level. Not quite, but in the same like brother games, it's Ghost of Tsushima loads probably about, I would say about 5 seconds faster, maybe more.
Oi, anyone here? Where are the lights at?
Okay. Gaming PC, that's a sick, dude, 4 PC setup on 1 monitor, are you insane? There's a mask up there.
Registration detected. Identify yourself, or I'll seal the exits, oh, hack your optic, and read you every drunken email you ever wrote until you starve.
No, not that.
Hello?
Sabine sent me.
Sabine's alive? Well, that's one piece of good news. I'm Bagley, DedSec's definitely not stolen, highly advanced AI assistant, and it seems I've been out of commission for a few months. Anyway,
oh, it's been a few
why don't you
months
go connect me to the
bombs?
DedSec network so I can become more powerful than you could possibly imagine? I mean, catch up on what I missed.
So that's the mask I got. Oh, it was just up there. God damn it. Oh, wait, there's something else.
Yes, there we are.
A floppy disk, bro? A relic? That counts as a relic? I guess this is near future. It's not right now. I was like, because a floppy disk wouldn't count as a goddamn relic. Definitely be old. Where am I going now? Am I going back downstairs?
Ah, that's it. I'm reconnected to the network. Downloading our database, news archives, and... Oh no. Terrorist group DedSec responsible for deadly bombings in London. Dalton Wolf dead? I leave you people alone for a second and you immediately cock it all up.
All good question, but if DedSec didn't do the bombings, who did?
There's a gap in my memory after Dalton... Well, let's be honest, after I disarmed the bomb at Parliament. I'm missing information about what happened after I was taken offline. But from what I can infer, an unknown hacker group identified only as Zero Day was involved. I believe this Zero Day staged the attacks and framed DedSec for their dirty work. Come to my terminal. Sabine is requesting a video call.
Oh, my hair is sick. Wait, so where is she? I thought she would just be in here. Why isn't she in the hideout?
Patching in Sabine Brandt now. I suggest you listen very closely to anything she has to say.
There you are. I'm glad you made it. Bagley, God, it's good to hear your demented little voice. Is your memory intact?
Not even slightly. The last record I have is of our HQ being raided. My only lead is a group known as Zero Day. Ring any bells?
No. But the HQ was attacked by some men in black, the same that were at Parliament. Maybe working together. We didn't stand a chance. They just gunned everyone down.
Holy shit. How did you get out?
I managed to escape through the sewers to Camden. A contact smuggled me out of the city and I've been hiding out in the north since.
Prudent. Your profile is red flagged as a high priority target in the city surveillance system. Even a partial recognition hit would have you hunted down and shot on sight.
These days, DedSec's about as well loved as a French football team. This shit is so cool, but, well, it's kind of a massive risk.
Listen, if anyone knows anything about risks, it's me. I lost everything and everyone. But it comes down to this. London is in a death spiral. And if DedSec can't pull it out, trust me, no one can. The city needs a resistance. And it starts with you.
Damn straight.
What do you say?
Who am I kidding? Yeah. Let's do it.
Excellent. New user registered. Welcome to DedSec.
I didn't know my character was, like, kind of goofy, but, like, didn't know what he actually
now,
wanted
to be
either.
Irresponsible of us to release you naked and mewling into the wild. You'll find equipment around the safe house that are essential items in your dead set.
Tech upgrades. Tech points. Tech points can be found throughout London. Use them to purchase tech upgrades, gadgets, and weapons. Purchase tech in the tech menu to obtain upgrade gadgets, weapons, and hacks. Equipping tech to change an operative's weapon or gadget. Use the edit function in the team menu. Purchase tech.
Kit.
Got it. Okay. So these I already have unlocked. Chase drone hacks. Okay. Do I want AR cloak, which I know what that is. It is really good. Or just a spider. I'll probably just go with the spider bot for now. But the next thing I'll get is an AR cloak. Team menu, edit. Oh, excuse me, guys. Dead sick weapons can be locked in the tech menu. Skins. Interesting. Look at these. Very cool.
We have a sophisticated technique for hiding your identity from facial recognition tech. It's called a mask. And while we're here, perhaps we can talk about updating your wardrobe. I mean, look at you. Come on.
Alright, I should have a few weapons, or a few skins, actually. That's the only thing I can actually buy. Let's see what's in my wardrobe. Outfits, misc. Masks, yeah. I'll probably go with this one, because it's like, literally, like, my favorite mask. Not that one, exactly, but... it's somewhat like that one. Okay, so I need to go to... want different shoes. Oh, wow, those are kind of garbage. Loungewear. Those are all bad too, except for these. Those are pretty sick. Like, that's just weird, and so are these. I don't want to buy those. A lot of these, which you can't see because I'm wearing Marcus's jacket from the second game. Let's go with this hat. Glasses. No. Bags. I'll probably go with the bag, like just the little bag. Oh, I can't. Let's go with the black one. Face wear. Cool. There's more that I missed? What? Where? Oh. Apparently there's just no hand wear for some reason. Sorry, it's a thing. I have to get rid of all the dots or it's gonna bother me. What other dots is there? Oh! There's more to it. There's earrings as well. What else is on here?
Okay. You've got all these fancy new toys, but it's also important to
wait,
know
why
basics.
Did...
you need to learn how to throw a punch and how to take one.
Miss, shut up
Albion
for a second.
Will escalate if you come at them with a gun and shoot you down. We want to avoid collateral damage. In DedSec, we tried to use guns only as a last resort.
Have you already met Connie Robinson? She owns the pub and is an old DedSec contact, not to mention a champion amateur boxer. Go to the practice ring and she'll show you how to stop flinching when someone cocks a punch at you.
I'm gonna use guns if I want to use guns. I hope they know that. I will use guns whenever I want. So we're gonna go in. Why is there a loading screen for this? Everything was right there in front of me. I'm going to the boxing
some basic strikes. Hit me. Don't be shy.
I did. I just punched you in the goddamn face.
You want to get in under my block. Find the weak point. That's it.
couldn't have done that better myself.
Oh, I hate the black screen though. Like, I don't like it. The fact that there's like 2 or 3 seconds of black screen.
Distance. Couldn't have done that better myself.
I wasn't ready for it. So I just punched in the face for no reason.
Just like that.
Got it. What the hell did you hit me for? It was a black screen. I couldn't do anything. Correct. Oh my god, I'm so sorry, I just bodied you. My man just beat a woman. What the hell? Bro, you didn't have to go this hard on her though. God damn. She got completely just bodied. She's dead. She's done.
Right, gear in order? Know enough not to punch yourself in the face or get shot for pulling out a gun too early? Brilliant. I'm working out how we find Zero Day and ruin their day, but I need someone with actual legs to do the legwork. Hope you're ready.
We have some damage control to do if we want to change the perception that we're a bunch of violent thugs. I'll let you be the judge of how best to handle yourself, but remember, you represent DedSec now.
Cool. So is this me actually being able to get into the open world now? Yep. Very nice. Very nice. We could actually go around, explore a little bit, see what the game has. Well, we're not gonna explore too much in this episode. We're gonna pretty much keep it strictly to the main missions for a little while. But for probably just this episode and the next maybe. And then maybe we'll have an episode where I just run around and do a few side missions. Why did it spawn the camera like that? There's darts. Let's go.
Okay, cool. I have no idea what I'm doing.
Make no mistake, London is under occupation. Armed mercenaries patrol our streets, allegedly to keep people safe, but really they're keeping the people scared.
Totally, right, yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say.
So, we have to ignite the will to resist in the people of London by showing them that Albion aren't the solution. They're the problem.
For that, we'll need information. I'm pushing 2 sets of coordinates to your optic.
Cheers, Bagley. I've identified 2 opportunities. One, we're going to disrupt some Albion propaganda. Remind the people it's not Albion's way or the highway. 2, we need intel about Albion operations if we want to throw a spanner in their plans. You game?
All right, yeah, that doesn't sound scary at all. Let's do it.
Brilliant. Let's get the people of London on board.
All right. Oh, so now, yeah, everything's opened up. This is something I was worried about, though. Like, if you go in here, they're actually, like, selling operatives. And that kind of worries me. I mean, I don't know how much these are. So the operatives are $10 each. Interesting. Yeah, I don't know how much I like that. But I put all these people here, so... I put her there because she had a weapon. I put him there because shorter team arrest time. I put him there because he has a different car, and I put him there because he has a different car. Because I know that's one of, like, the better things to do, is to, kind of just get situated with everything. How would I do this? Where did spawn my car?
What's he saying, Bagsy?
Albion just placed him under severe data restriction.
Why?
Well, he's been looking into a couple of their field officers' dodgy side projects. You know how Albion feels about transparency.
Old lady, hold on.
Albion wouldn't bother with that if there wasn't nothing to find. So, let's find it, yeah?
Right, here's the coordinates of the goons in question. See if you can't work out what they're up to.
Interesting. I'm digging it. I really am. Let's see, which one do I want to go for? Go for the closer one first. Okay, this motorcycle actually feels weird. I thought it would feel much nicer. It feels very strange. Okay. It sounds so weird. Actually, like a good guy to recruit or something. I don't know how parking works in England, London. Restricted areas. Restricted areas are dangerous. Scout. Stealth. Yeah, okay. It's your basic
Albion
stuff.
Albion have established an operational base in the Royal Court of Justice.
So, that's Albion actually takes over the courts and suddenly everyone they don't like just ends up in jail. Yeah, I'm sure that's just a coincidence.
Exactly. But it likely means there's information here about how Albion are targeting dissenters, the who and the why.
Oh,
we need that data if we're going to disrupt their operation.
Well, I tried. Get wrecked. Man got bodied. What a very big gun you have. Did it help you in the end, though? Bitch. Alright. Well, I guess I could have actually just used the spider bot for this part. I could have, like, never came in here if I didn't want to. I mean, I think it's clear for me to just run around. Yeah, so the only thing so far that's a bit of, like, I just don't like is probably just the, like, the way the vehicles handle. But I think I might, just over time, that'll feel better. But overall, so far, it's like, it feels like a solid game. Let's pick this up. Okay, my, that was very broken. Climb.
Badly.
Yeah, I'm loving this.
A list of what Albion consider high-value targets that are threats to the peaceful running of London. See here, a journalist, and this one runs a community shelter. Good God, bar your doors.
WT fuck?
All suspected of sowing rebellion.
I need to pick someone who talks normal. Why he say WT fuck?
Albion is systematically arresting people even before they rise up to help us. Well done. Now, let's disrupt some of Albion's propaganda and give some hope to the people.
You got it. I mean, even just now, like, I'm starting to get used to it a little more. It just seems like the motorcycle itself, it doesn't turn, like, as much as you would expect for, like, how much I'm pushing the stick to the side. But I think I can get used to it, without a doubt. Oh! It's scary because, like, Watch Dogs is known for, like, if you hit a car, like, at all on a motorcycle, you die. You just fly. Oh wait, hold on actually. I wanna photo mode. Oh, that's actually sick. That's a nice picture. That's a sick picture. Just like that. That's pretty cool. Alright, let's keep going. Yeah, I'm excited because this is pretty much, we're gonna be playing this game up until the release of the next gen consoles. And if I'm being honest with you guys, I have no idea what we're going to be playing next on the channel. I really don't. After this, like, it'll probably be nothing for a little bit. But I'm not sure yet. Some cash. Okay, it looks like I'm breaking this billboard.
Hey, good news. I just scratched off my Albion propaganda bingo card. Guess they don't want us forgetting who's in charge, right?
There's going to be that much less once you're done here. Let's give Camden a break from these eyesores.
Piss easy. I got this.
Oh, there's something up there I have to hack. Is there an easy way up?
Oh. If you hijack that scissor lift, you could use it to access the rooftop.
Okay. Oh. Let me get on it. There we go. Oh, I guess I could just go straight up right here, huh? That's probably what they wanted me to do. That would make more sense. Ooh. That's as high. What? Alright, well, that's the size we're going. Yep, I knew you can climb these. I saw that in the gameplay. Oh, I can't jump right there. This isn't Assassin's Creed, so... I've been playing so much Assassin's Creed lately, trying to get the platinum for Brotherhood. And oh my god, has it been a real grind for that game. I'm still not even close to done. But I'll get there one day. I mean, I think I'm gonna go for the platinum for this game. It seems easy enough. Oh wow. Oh, I have to actually earn that. I'm gonna actually have to end the video in a second, guys.
Nicely done. That'll get people's attention. Let them know someone is standing up to Albion. Light the spark that they can stand up to.
If nothing else, it'll relieve their eye strain.
What now?
Alright, guys. Well, this is where we're gonna end part one of Watch Dogs Legion.
We're already seeing results from what you've done. That list we found named a journalist in Camden who's been investigating Albion. We reached out and he's got information that can help us. I think you should meet with him.
Send me the coordinates.
Alright guys, well this is where we're going to end this episode of Watch Dogs Legion. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Please do comment down below what you guys want to see on the channel in the future. I'll see you guys very soon in the next one. Peace out.